Hello everybody, I'm Marion Doom, I'm the director of the Ghent University Museum.
I'm Michael Marien, I'm responsible for marketing communications for the GUM, the Ghent University Museum.
So the GUM is a brand new and very first museum of the Ghent University, and we were supposed to open on the 18th of March, but unfortunately we couldn't open due to the COVID-19 crisis, and we wanted to share with you our experiences on not opening and how to deal with that during the lockdown and how to deal with the idea of a new opening. So the GUM is a forum for science, doubt and art. We are a science museum, but in our museum, we dive into the head of the scientists. So we focus on the process of science and scientific thinking. You could call it the Museum of Enlightenment, and we search for the connection with the arts in every possible way. Our key word is doubt, you could say. And so we've been working on this project for quite a while, I'd say maybe 10 years already. And well, the 18th of March was supposed to be our big day, our big opening day. We were opening for VIPs on the 18th, 650 people with the reception and the speeches, the usual climax for us as a team as well, let's say. And the days that followed, we were opening for the academic staff and students on the Friday. And in the weekend, we were organizing a big science festival where the big public would enter our museums with lots of activities, talks, performances, and so on.
And we started our campaign on the 4th of March, so 17 days before the festival. And what you see on this picture is the famous Ghent graffiti street, the street art street. It's almost like a touristic attraction. But we do some, we will talk about this later, some collaborations with the Ghent street art scene. And we knew that they wanted to give this street a kind of new restart. So this was the basis of a really nice collaboration we did with them. And what you see here is what we did. We painted this whole street white. Well, the street artists did it themselves. Not just because we like to paint streets white, but because we wanted to launch our new vision for the new museum, which was sometimes you have to start with a blank sheet to come up with new insights. Welcome inside the head of the scientist. We launched this with a press conference in that street and with a graffiti jam. And on top of that, we also launched a book, not just a book, it's this book. It looks like a real book. It has an introduction of 2 pages in which we explain the vision of the new museum, and the rest of the book is white. We invited the readers to write their own book, to write down their ideas, to delete them, to try again, to think, to doubt, all this in this book. So this book represented our vision together with the action we did in that graffiti street. This launch was quite successful. We spread the book on an edition of 30,000 all over the university, to all teachers of secondary schools in Flanders, in libraries, in bookshops, and so on. It was a big national success in the press. We also had some collaborations with Belgian media. So we put already the GUM on the map from day one. And that was also the starting point for our bigger campaign, which was spread in outdoor communications and online communications, social and print. So it was really a 360 campaign that we launched. But at the same moment, we had this sword of Damocles hanging above us, because since some weeks the COVID-19 crisis had started, but Marianne will tell you a lot more about that.
Yeah, so we were heading towards this climax of an opening, but in the same time we knew this crisis of a virus was hanging above our heads, so we were in like a double gear. One gear going in a very fast speed towards an opening and trying to finish our exhibition. And the other gear was well, was putting on the brakes because we didn't really know whether we could open or not. We were at that time communicating with both the cultural and museum sector. So our neighboring museum is the Museum of Fine Arts, who had a very big exhibition on Van Eyck. They were seeing thousands of visitors every day. So we thought as long as they are still allowing visitors to enter, we can still open. On the other hand, we were communicating with, of course, the board of the university. So heading towards that 18th of March, we had a daily talks with both the board of the university and let's say the museum sector in Ghent. At a certain point, we got the call from the board of the university saying we couldn't open anymore, that we had to go into some kind of a lockdown. That was before the Flemish government or the Belgian government announced the national lockdown. And looking at it backwards now, I think that decision that we decided not to open before the big national lockdown was a good decision. We received very positive feedback on that, because that now we came across as a museum that dared to take the decision not to open. During the lockdown, of course, we had to keep our connections warm. We had to be present in another way. We were flowing on this very nice and big campaign towards the opening, but we had to keep those bubbles boiling, let's say. So what did we do digitally during the lockdown? We had, for example, an interview for the launch of my book, in which I explained the vision of the Museum of Doubt, soon to be available in English as well. We had the curator battle, where a museum in Yorkshire invited colleagues with different challenges in the curator battle. So we decided to go completely digital. And in the meantime, we still had no sight on the new date of the opening. So we had different scenarios on how to open and what is coming next. What we're hoping now, this is scenario maybe 30, is that we're opening at the end of September in a very, let's say, flexible way. Well, first of all, we're opening in July for teachers, but teachers only. So we invite them to come and do a test opening, and we also got some feedback from them. July and August, and then in October or the end of September, we will do nocturnals. And those nocturnals, well, they give two advantages. First, it's still it gives this kind of celebration vibe, but also it's very flexible in how we organize these nocturnals. We can do nocturnals for 50 people, but we can also do them for 200 people. So that kind of flexibility allows us to fix a date and work towards an opening in October. The whole month of October after those nocturnals will be our opening month. And in the weekends, we will open for the big audience with the program that we had originally planned in March. But we will spread it in time and place maybe also a bit. So that's our goal. That's what we're looking forward right now. And we hope to welcome you soon, and certainly in October, November, in our new, brand new museum, the GOM. Maybe also come and take a look at our new street artist project. This is a drawing of Roa. Roa is a Ghentian, very nice artist, very nice guy also. We've been thinking about this project for quite a while. We were supposed to launch this also with a big celebration, but now it happened in lockdown, which is a different kind of setting, but equally nice. So come and see our new street artist project.
So thank you. We are really looking forward to welcome you in the new museum from October on, and we hope to see you in real life one of the coming months and maybe one of the coming years at Universiteit. Thank you very much.